In this Onshape video, I'd like to go through the basics of how to work with angles or diagonals on parts. So what I'm going to go through is basic number 7. So I'm going to go ahead and activate my basic shapes folder, and I'm going to go ahead and create a new empty document. Okay, so there's a lot of different ways that I could do this part, and I'm actually going to do it a couple different ways. The first way is just to go ahead and block it out and think more subtractively. So I'm going to go ahead and create a new sketch on my front plane. I'll go ahead and square it up, and I'm going to draw just a rectangle. So now I need to think about the dimensions. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 quarters across, or 1.5 inches, and 1, 2, 3, 4 quarters tall, or 1 inch. Let's go ahead and throw those two dimensions on there. So I've got 1 inch tall and 1.5 inches wide. And we'll call that done. Everything is black, everything is completely constrained. We'll finish sketch and turn off our work features. So now we're going to go ahead and extrude that a total distance of, looks like 2 quarters. So I have 1/2 inch. So I'll go ahead and say extrude, I'll click my shape, I'm going to change that to 0.5. Hit enter to be able to view it, and go ahead and accept that extrusion. Okay, so now what I want to do is go ahead and get rid of that corner. So now what I want to do is go ahead and get rid of that corner. So I'm going to go ahead and do a sketch on the front, go ahead and line it up, and this is one time where I'll actually use the line tool. I don't use the line tool very often. Most of the time it's for diagonals. So I'm going to go ahead and link it onto the top somewhere. Be careful about linking it onto the square, because that may not be true. It may not be exactly in the middle. So just link somewhere onto it, and same thing, be careful about linking directly into the middle of it, just somewhere onto it. Okay, I don't know exactly what angle it's sitting at. I do, but we'll pretend that I don't. I'm going to look at the dimensions that I've got. Now, if you're having a hard time trying to imagine where these two corners come into contact with each other, well, let's just do it backwards. So from the back edge forward to where that red line starts, I've got 1, 2, 3 quarters. So I'll grab my dimension tool, and not only can I dimension to lines, I can also dimension to points. So I'm going to select this outside line and then the point to where my diagonal starts. I'll go ahead and call that 3/4. I'll do the same thing to the bottom. So I can see that it only goes up 1/4 from the bottom. So then again, ignoring this entire section that's missing. So I'll click on the bottom and then I'll click on my point. So 0.25. Everything is turned black. That means it's completely constrained. That's all I needed to know. Yep, that's it. All I need to know is where the diagonal is going to start and where the diagonal is going to stop. I could then go ahead and put an isometric, finish my sketch, extrude, pick only the little triangle by itself. I'll do that as a remove and then change blind to through all. And that's it. That's the entire part. But I really could have done all of that in one step. Instead of doing it in two, I could have done it all in the original extrusion. So if I came back up to the original sketch, and we can say that's what I've got, I could have gone ahead and drawn that diagonal in here. So I'll go ahead and draw my diagonal straight across, go ahead and throw my two dimensions on, just like I did a moment ago, 0.25, and then 0.75. And Onshape doesn't care that this corner is already filled in. When I go to extrude it, I'm just not going to pick that. So when I go to extrusion, just don't pick the corner, pick the bottom of it. I can say 1/2 inch and I get the exact same solution. So rather than doing it in two steps, I've done it in one step. Then I actually have one more option that I really like. I'm going to go ahead and fill all of that in. So I'm going to imagine that I had only done a rectangle. That was just a block. I have a chamfer tool that'll do that for me. The chamfer tool really is a nice tool to be able to do edge treatments or corners. I really have three different options. I have equal distance, I have two different distances, and then I have a distance and an angle. So what I really need to do is figure out what is this distance? What is the value that needs to be put into there? What has to do with the rise and run of that specific diagonal? So if I look at it, the run is 1, 2, 3 quarters, and the rise is 1, 2, 3 quarters. Well, that actually means it's at a 45 degree because I have the same rise and run. So what is the number that it wants? It wants to know how much of that corner is disappearing. And you can look at it underneath it just as well as you can above it. So 3/4, 0.75 is the number that I want. Equal distance is fine because I've got the same two numbers. I can just click that corner. Oops, 0.75, I'll type that in. Hit enter, and there it is. If you want to prove to yourself that you actually did it right, I can come down here and click on this line, As soon as I do, it tells me that it's 0.25, which is exactly what it was supposed to be. I can come up here and I can click on this line and tells me it's 0.75, exactly what it's supposed to be. So that's it. To be able to use diagonals, you can do it sometimes in the original sketch. You can do it afterwards and cut it off, or I can use the chamfer tool if I can figure out the dimensions that I need. And that's it for basic number 7.